that Palilolo Channel down there, it's 8.5 miles wide between Molokai and Maui. Believe it or not, over the years, 16 people have actually swum across. Humpback whales like to swim through these channels too. They come down here from Alaska in the winter to give birth to their young in the warm waters, then swim back for the summer. If we keep our eyes open, maybe we'll see one. Maui is the state's second largest island. It was formed by two volcanoes, Haleakala, which is over 10,000 feet tall, and another one which formed the West Maui Mountains. The valley between the mountains used to be underwater, but over time the valley floor rose to form Maui as it looks today. Some people say that if the polar ice caps melted, the valley would be underwater again. People on Maui like to say, Maui no ka oi. Maui is the best. Even from up here you can see that it's a pretty special place. That's the small town of Lahaina down below. In the early 1800s, it was the capital of Kamehameha's Hawaiian Kingdom. Eventually, the capital moved to Honolulu, but Lahaina was still booming, mostly as a stopover for whaling ships. In those days, more than 500 whaling ships stopped at Lahaina every year. Today, tourism is the main industry. Lots of great shops and restaurants down there, not to mention one of the world's largest banyan trees. One day a few years ago, I was flying right around here pretty low, and I looked down at the water, and a humpback whale breached right where I was looking. He jumped right out of the water as if he knew I was watching. To this day, it's one of the most amazing things I've ever seen. If you want to see Haleakala and the observatory on top, you'd better start climbing now. The mountain tops out at 10,000 feet above sea level. See that little island? It's Molokini, the top of an extinct volcano. The crescent shape protects the reef from the elements, so it's one of Hawaii's most popular dive sites. There are about 250 different species of fish down there. See that airport at the north end of the valley? That's Kahului. Hundreds of tourists arrive there every day from all over the world. We could land there, but it's pretty busy with all the airliners. So let's just keep heading east to Hana. The Hana Highway from Kahului to Hana is right down there. It's 52 miles long, has 600 hairpin turns, and 56 one-lane bridges. I know. I've counted. To drive the highway takes almost 3 hours, which is why, unlike the rest of Maui, Hana has remained a pretty sleepy little town. We'll cover the same distance in about 15 minutes. I grew up just outside of Hana, right down there. My dad drove me to school every day along the Hana Highway. That's Hana Airport up ahead. If you think it's beautiful here, you're not alone. Mark Twain, Jack London, and Charles Lindbergh all fell in love with Hana. In fact, Lindbergh spent the last years of his life in Hana, and his grave is right around here. The locals get annoyed by all the airplanes circling it, so let's just head for the airport and land. As you approach the airport, slow to 140 knots or less, and lower the landing gear. You can use the speed brake if you need to get down in a hurry. Lower the flaps as you continue slowing. You want about 75 knots on final. didn't see any whales. It's hard to know exactly where to find them. Well, you did a great job. All checked out as far as I'm concerned. Let's grab a bite in town, then we'll head back to Molokai.